नमस्कार माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन। इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द डिजाइन प्रोसीजर ऑफ वॉर्म गियर बाय सॉल्विंग एग्जांपल। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ एग्जांपल नंबर वन, इन विच डिजाइन 20 डिग्री इन्वोल्यूट वॉर्म एंड गियर टू ट्रांसमिट द 10 किलोवाट विथ वॉर्म rotating at 1400 RPM and to obtain a speed reduction of 12 gem 1, the distance between the shaft is 225 mm. Now first of all, given data, the pressure angle phi is 20 degree, and power to be transmitted P is equal to 10 kilowatt is equal to 10,000 watt. Speed of worm is 1400 RPM, velocity ratio VR is equal to 12, and center distance X is equal to 225 mm. Okay, now here we have to design the involute worm gear, so in which we have to find the different dimensions, okay, of worm and worm gear, okay, diameter, then length, outer diameter, number of teeth. Okay, so let us start first. So we know that the value of x by ln, it will be minimum corresponding to the cot cube lambda is equal to vr. Okay, so we have discussed in the design procedure. Okay, so the value of x by l, you know that the value of x by ln, x is the center distance, okay, so will be minimum, we can say will be minimum corresponding to what, cot cube lambda is equal to vr and is equal to 12, or you can say cot lambda is equal to 2.29, okay, by taking the cube root. So from that we can say angle lambda is equal to 23.6 degree. Okay, now we know that the ratio, that x by ln is equal to 1 by 2 pi into bracket 1 upon sin lambda plus VR upon cos lambda. Okay, now put the value in this equation, x is equal to 225 divided by ln, okay, is equal to 1 by 2 pi 1 upon sin 23.6 degree plus VR is equal to 12 upon cos 23.6 degree. Okay, so therefore we can say 1 upon 2 pi into bracket 1 upon sin 23.6 is equal to 2.5 plus, here it is 13.1, so is equal to 2.5 totally, okay, 2.5. So therefore we can say ln is equal to 225 divided by 2.5 is equal to 90 mm. Okay, so therefore this is ln is the normal lead. So axial lead, we know that axial lead L is equal to ln upon cos lambda. So ln is equal to 90 upon cos 23.6 degree. Okay, so therefore it is 98.2 mm. Okay. Now we have to find the velocity. Okay. From the that velocity ratio, the number of start or thread on the worm, that is the n. Okay. So from the design data book, we can find the value of number of start or thread. So according to the velocity ratio 12, we can say the number of starts or the thread on the worm is given by n, or we can say TW, teeth on worm, is equal to 4. Okay? Number of start is equal to 4. Now axial pitch of the threads on the worm. Okay, axial pitch, that is the PA. So axial pitch PA is equal to L by 4. So L is equal to 98.2 divided by 4 is equal to 24.55 mm. Value of axial pitch. Now module. We know that the module M. Module M is equal to PA by pi. So PA is equal to 24.55 upon pi. So is equal to 7.8 mm. Okay. We get the module is equal to 7.8 mm. Now let us take the standard value, okay, corresponding to this 7.8. So the standard value of module M is equal to 8 mm. Okay, M is equal to 8 mm. Now axial pitch of the threads on the worm. Okay, so axial pitch that we have find, that now exact, the actual axial pitch, okay, is equal to PA. So PA is equal to pi into M. So pi into 8. So is equal to 25.136 millimeter. Okay. So axial pitch PA is equal to 25.136 millimeter. Now similarly, let us find the axial lead of the thread on the worm. Okay. So that axial lead of the thread on the worm, that is the L. So L is equal to PA into N. So PA is equal to 25.136 into 4. So is equal to 100.544 mm. Okay. So axial lead is equal to 100.544 mm. Now let us the normal lead. Okay. Let us find the normal lead. So LN. So value of LN is equal to L cos lambda. Okay. So is equal to 100.544 into cos lambda is equal to 23.6 degree. Okay. So therefore you will get it is 92 millimeter. Okay. LN is equal to 92 millimeter. This is our answer. Okay. Normal lead. Now we know that the center distance, center distance x is equal to, as we put the equation, x is equal to ln by 2 pi into bracket 1 upon sin lambda plus vr upon cos lambda. Okay. So therefore, put the equation, ln is equal to 92 upon 2 pi. Okay, so that we have find that 1 upon sine 23.6 is equal to 2.5. Okay, plus 12 upon VR is equal to 12. 12 upon cos lambda is equal to, you know that it is 13.1. We have find already. Okay, so therefore we can say x is equal to 14.6 63 into 2.5 plus 13.1. So therefore, center distance, exact center distance is 230 millimeter. This is our answer. Now let us DW. DW is the pitch circle diameter of worm, or we can say PCD of worm. Okay. So therefore, we can say 10 lambda. 10 lambda is equal to L by pi DW. Okay. So from that, we can say therefore, DW is equal to L upon pi 10 lambda. Pi 10 lambda. Okay. So therefore, L is equal to, we have find 100.544 divided by pi 10 23.6 degree. So therefore, we can say DW is equal to 73.24 mm. Okay. So the pitch circle diameter of worm is equal to 73.24 millimeter. Now velocity ratio is 12 and worm has the quadrupole threads, that is the N or TW is equal to 4. So therefore, number of teeth on the worm gear, okay, number of teeth on the worm gear, that is TG. Okay, so TG is equal to velocity ratio VR into N. VR into N. So VR is equal to 12, N is equal to 4. So 48 teeth on gears are 48. Okay. Now, from the table, or we can from the design data book, we find that the face length of the worm or the length of the threaded portion, that is the LW. Okay. So equation of that LW is equal to, can say PA. Okay. So PA into 4.5 plus 0.02 TW. Okay. So now this PA or the PC is equal to 25.136 into bracket 4.5 plus 0.02 TW is equal to 4. So is equal to 115 millimeters. Okay. LW is equal to 115 millimeters. Now this length, it should be increased by 25 to 30 mm for the feed marks produced by the vibrating grinding wheel as it leaves the thread root. So therefore, let us take this LW is equal to 140 mm. Okay. Now, that depth of the tooth, okay, depth of the tooth, H is equal to 0.623 into P, PA or PC. So 0.623 into 25.136 is equal to 15.66 millimeter. This is our answer. Addendum A. Addendum A is equal to 0.286 into PA or PC is equal to 0.286 into 25.136 is equal to 7.2 millimeter addendum. Now outside diameter of worm. Okay. So outside diameter of worm is DOW is equal to DW plus 2A. So therefore, DW is equal to 73.2 24 plus 2 into 7.2. So therefore, outside diameter of the worm is equal to 87.64 millimeter. Okay. So this is the design of worm. Now let us find out the design of worm gear. Okay. So design of worm gear. Write down here. Design of worm gear. Okay. So for that, first of all, let us find the piece circle diameter of gear. It is DG. So DG is equal to AM into TG. Right? So therefore, 8 into 48, so is equal to 384 millimeter. Okay? 384 millimeter. Now we convert it into the meter, so 0.384 meter. So pitch circle diameter, okay, pitch circle diameter of the gear is 0.384 meter. Now that outside diameter of the gear, so outside diameter of the gear, it is DOG is equal to DG plus from 0.8903 PC. So is equal to, we have find DG is equal to 384 plus 0.8903 into 25.136 is equal to 406.4 millimeter. Okay, now let us throat diameter DT. So throat diameter DT is equal to DG plus 0.572 PA. Okay, so is equal to DG is equal to 384 plus 0.572 into 25.136. So therefore, throat diameter is equal to 398.4 millimeter. Okay. Now face width B. So face width B is equal to 2.15 into PA plus 5 mm. So is equal to 2.15 into 25.136. plus 5, so therefore face width B is equal to 59 mm. Okay, now let us check the design of this worm gearing from the standpoint of tangential load, dynamic load, static load, wear load, and heat dissipation. Okay, now let us check for the tangential load. Check for tangential load. Okay. So for that, let us Ng. Ng is the speed of the worm gearing, revolution per minute. So therefore, we can say velocity ratio Vr is equal to Nw by Ng. Okay. So, or you can say this Ng. Okay. Number of speed of the gear is equal to Nw upon Vr. Okay. So therefore, Vr is, Nw is equal to 1400 and Vr is equal to 12. So therefore, you can say Ng, speed of the gear, is equal to 116.7 RPM. Okay. Revolution per minute. Now torque transmitted. So torque transmitted T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi ng. So power is equal to 10,000 watt into 60 divided by 2 pi ng is equal to 116.7. So therefore, torque transmitted is equal to 818.2 Newton into meter. Okay. Now tangential load acting on the gear. So that tangential load acting on the gear, okay, is equal to WT. WT is equal to 2 into torque T upon DG. Okay. So T by R, WT is equal to, and R is equal to DG by 2. So therefore 2 into 818.2 upon DG. DG is equal to 0.384. So is equal to 4260 Newton. Okay. Now let us find the pitch line velocity V. So pitch line velocity V is equal to pi DG NG by 60. So is equal to pi DG is equal to 0.384, ng is equal to 116.7 divided by 60. Okay, so therefore pitch line velocity is equal to V is equal to 2.35 meter per second. Now let us velocity factor CV. Okay, so velocity factor CV is equal to 6 upon 6 plus V. So therefore 6 upon 6 plus 2.35, so is equal to 0.72 velocity factor. Now tooth form factor for 20 degree involute teeth. So Y, value of tooth form factor, Y is equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 by TG. So is equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by 48. So is equal to 0.3135. Okay, now since this worm gear is generally made of phosphorus bronze, therefore taking the allowable static stress for this phosphorus bronze, that is sigma O, is equal to 84 Newton per mm square. So let us take sigma O is equal to 84 Newton per mm square, 84 megapascal, or we can say 84 Newton per mm square. So equation of tangential load, WT is equal to sigma O into CV into B into pi into M into Y. Now put value in this equation, 84, sigma O is equal to 84, CV is equal to 0.72, B is equal to 59 into pi, M is equal to 8, and Y is equal to 0.135. Okay, so therefore tangential load WT is equal to 12,110 Newton tangential load. Okay, now since this is more than the tangential load acting on the gear, that is the 4,260 Newton, therefore this design is safe. Okay, so here this WT is greater than that load, 4260 Newton. So therefore, the design is safe for the standpoint of view tangential load. Now check for the dynamic load. Okay. Check for dynamic load. Okay. So we know that the WD is equal to WT upon CV. So 12110 divided by 0.72, so is equal to 16,820 Newton. Okay, so this is more than that WT, that is 4260. So therefore, this design is safe standpoint of view, dynamic load. Now, check for static load. Check for static load. Okay, so the flexural endurance limit for the phosphorus bronze, that is sigma is equal to 168 newton per mm square. So our equation WS is equal to sigma E into B into pi into M into Y. Now put the value in this equation 168, B is equal to 59 into pi, M is equal to 8, 0.135. Okay, so therefore the static load is equal to 33,635 newton. Okay, so this is much more greater than the WT. Okay, so therefore the design is safe. Now check for wear. Okay, check for wear load. So assuming the material for the worm is as hardened steel, therefore the design data book we find that for the hardened steel worm and phosphorus bronze worm gear, the value of load stress factor K, value of load stress factor is equal to 0.55 newton per mm square. Okay, so therefore the wear load, WW, wear load WW is equal to, we can say DG into B into K. So therefore DG is equal to 384 into 59 into 0.55. So is equal to 12,461 newton. So it is more than that WT, 4,260 newton. So therefore our design is safe. Okay, so therefore we can say design is safe for tangential static dynamic and wear load. Okay, now let us check for heat dissipation. Check for heat dissipation. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the efficiency of the worm gearing eta. So for that, the rubbing velocity, we have to find the rubbing velocity. And the rubbing velocity Vr is equal to pi dW nW upon cos lambda. Okay, so now put the value here in this equation, pi dW is equal to 0.07324 nW is equal to 1400 divided by cos 23.6 degree. So therefore the rubbing velocity Vr is equal to 351.6 meter per minute. Okay, here dW is taken in meter. Now coefficient of friction mu. Okay, find the value of coefficient of friction mu. So mu is equal to 0.025 plus Vr upon 18,000. So therefore 0.025 plus Vr is equal to, we already find 351.6 divided by 18,000. So therefore coefficient of friction mu is equal to 0.0445. Okay, why we have taken this equation? Because here the Vr is greater than 180. 180 meter per minute. That's why we have taken this equation. Now angle of friction phi 1. So angle of friction phi 1 is equal to tan inverse mu is equal to tan inverse mu is equal to 0.0445. Okay. So therefore, the value of phi 1 is equal to 2.548 degree. Okay. Now let us find efficiency eta. So efficiency eta is equal to 10 lambda upon 10 lambda plus phi 1. Okay. So therefore 1023.6 degree upon 10 23.6 plus 51 2.548. So therefore from that we can say it is 0.4369 divided by 0.4909, so is equal to 0.89, so is equal to 89%. So the efficiency is 89%. Now assuming the 25% overload, okay, so the heat generated, is QG is equal to 1.25 P, okay, 25% overload P into 1 minus eta, okay. So therefore 1.25 into P is equal to 10,000, P is equal to 10,000 into 1 minus 0.89. So therefore heat generated is equal to 1375 watt. Okay. Now let us projected area. Okay. Projected area, that is, so projected area AW is equal to pi by 4 into dW square. So is equal to pi by 4, dW is equal to 73.24 square. So therefore AW is equal to 4,214 mm square. Now projected area for the worm gear, that is the AG. Okay, AG is equal to pi by 4 dG square. So therefore pi by 4 dG is equal to 384 square. So therefore 115,827 mm square. That is 115,827 mm square. Now total projected area of the worm and worm gear, A is equal to AW plus AG. Okay. So therefore, put the both the value 4,214 plus 115,827. So total area, okay, total area is equal to 120,041 mm square. Now convert it into the meter square, so is equal to 120,041 into 10⁻⁶ meter square. Now heat dissipating capacity. So heat dissipating capacity, that is the QD. So QD is equal to A T2 minus T1 into K. Okay. So area 120,041 into 10⁻⁶, T2 minus T1, and that K is equal to 378. Okay. So therefore QD is equal to 45.4 into T2 minus T1. Now the heat generated, it must be dissipated in order to avoid the overheating of the drive. So therefore we can say the QG is equal to QD. Okay. So therefore we can say T2 minus T1 is equal to 1375. That is the QG. 1375 is the QG divided by 45.4. So is equal to 30.3 degree centigrade. Now, this temperature limit, this T2 minus T1 is within the safe limit, is within safe limit of 27 to 38 degree centigrade. Okay, so therefore we can say design is safe from the standpoint of heat. Okay, so now I hope you can understand very well. Thank you. Thank you very much.